Hello, I'm Aaron Beeman, Global Lead for Retail and E-Commerce at AMD, and I'm here at NRF 2025 with our ISV partner, Radius AI. I'm joined by Robert Hubbard, who's VP of Sales. Robert, maybe tell me a little bit about some of the trends that you're seeing here at NRF this year.
Yeah, so there's a lot of AI talk. So if you look at the schedule, you see it's like 70% AI discussions. So a lot of customers very interested in what's real, what kind of things do you do? It's a very, very broad topic, right? So I think that there's an awful lot of folks walking up to us and saying, okay, how are you different? Or when you say AI, what do you mean? That's been the most common theme. Or like, how do you compare against RFID, for example, right? So there's a lot of discussions about how do I handle clothing versus packaged goods? So that's been the majority of the question.
Excellent.
Yeah.
You know, it's been a pleasure partnering with Radius AI now for more than a year.
Yep.
Maybe tell us a little bit about your products and your solutions and how AMD is helping enable the great things that you're doing.
Yeah, so we have a number of deployments together at this time, and a lot of it is the way that Radius started, which is kind of how we actually started with AMD, is a lot of ceiling camera AI. So that's a very common ask, right? It's a lot of folks are using old cameras with NVRs and they're just recording into perpetuity, right? So the issue is they want to get those to be AI enabled as much as possible. So in the cases where we've worked with you guys, it's mainly about putting video feeds into the GPUs and the CPUs with you guys, helping them get real-time data, metadata off of the video. Most of that video does not then need to be backhauled or recorded, right? Because it keeps clips and it's smarter. If you have an incident in the store, for example, with our solution we've got with you, if somebody has a loss prevention issue or they've like eating food or something and not paying for it, or a slip and fall, or just people counting, general things that are going on, gas stations, pump to store conversion, that kind of thing. So a lot of that has been what we've been working with AMD on. And now we've gone really to sort of the end of that customer journey, which is checkout. So that also adds more AMD opportunity in that each one of the checkouts needs to have a compute device. So we're going from camera to checkout.
Awesome. So Shop Assist is your self-checkout technology. I'd love to see a demo.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's have the team do the demo.
Excellent.
Yep.
So what we've done is developed a solution that essentially speeds up transactions. And we do that by automatically detecting products when they're placed on the counter. So I'll give a demonstration. All right, I have four products here. And then you can see that I have all four products here on the POS as well. Our solution caters to different types of customer behavior, right? So when customers place their product on the counter, they might not always do it in such an organized way. They might throw their products on the counter or stack them as well. So I'll show you how we can also handle these types of situations. So there are two deodorants that are stacked there, and you can see the quantity has increased to two. Our goal is to create a solution that really caters to different types of customers' behaviors. We want to anticipate everything. And you can also see here that we can handle age-verified items. So we have this Mike's Hotter Lemonade, which has alcohol, and it'll ask the cashier that it's an age-restricted item, so they can confirm it here. And let's say that there is a seasonal product, right? A product that has changed its packaging for the season, and the model has never seen it before. So I'll place it like this. So let's pretend for the demo that this is a new product. It'll show up as an unknown object. So we know what we don't know, okay? But we also have barcode detection capability. So if I turn this over so that the barcode is visible, then we'll see that the Doritos also shows up on the POS here as well. That's basically our solution. Thank you.